What a blessed day for the life of the church, for the Diocese of Raleigh, for through the power of the Holy Spirit, with the imposition of hands and the prayer of consecration, the Lord our God gives us our newest priest. What a blessed day for all of us, dear friends, to celebrate the gift of priesthood, to remember all those priests in our lives who have been and continue to be powerful instruments of God's infinite mercy and love. What a blessed day for Bishop Gosman, me, Monsignor Brockman, and all of our brother priests to welcome Vic into the beautiful fraternity that is ours. What a blessed day for his dear sisters and family members and so many friends to join together in thanking God for leading Vic to this sacred, this joyful moment in his life. To thank you, Vic, for your enthusiastic yes to God's call. To thank Father Ned and Monsignor Clay and all who have been a part of your formation and training, including Monsignor Pryor and Monsignor Diamond, the rector and vice rector from St. Charles Seminary, who are with us here today. And what a blessed day for all of us, dear friends, to renew our commitment to be faithful to the particular vocations God has given to us. And Vic, what a blessed time to be ordained a priest. As we come to the conclusion of this year that our Holy Father has designated the year for priests. And we know that in giving us this year, our Holy Father has asked all priests to deepen their commitment to the interior life so that they may offer a more forceful and incisive witness to the gospel in today's world. And so, we have called upon the powerful intercession of St. John Vianney, the patron of all priests, in this, the 150th anniversary of his death. In a beautiful biography of St. John Vianney, on the cover, there is a picture of a young boy who led John Vianney to Ars, to the village where he would serve as priest. And it is said that John Vianney spoke these words to the little boy upon his arrival. You have shown me the way to ours. Now I will show you the way to heaven. Vic, something tells me that in this modern world with navigation systems, you will not need much help to find your way to New Bern. If you do, Monsignor Lewis will come to help you. I said to Vic last night when I gave him his assignment at St. Paul, I repeated the words that my bishop said to me when he gave me my first assignment. Father, I am sending you to one of the finest pastors in the diocese. If there is a problem, it is not the pastor. Vic, although you will be able to find your way to your first priestly assignment, something tells me, though, that like all priests, you may need to be reminded at times with God's grace that in the midst of so many parish responsibilities and demands, your most important priority at every moment, at all times, is to be a spiritual leader, to be the heart, and the voice, and the hands of the Good Shepherd, to be the one who will show them the way to heaven. And St. Paul today tells you how. Tend to the flock of God in your midst. And Jesus repeats those beautiful words to you on the day of your ordination, as he did to Peter. Feed my sheep. If you are going to tend to God's flock and feed and nurture God's people, you must nurture your spiritual life. For what do the people of St. Paul's and New Bern and all of God's people need more than ever in today's age? Holy priests, faithful priests, and joyful priests. And so, in just a few moments, the entire church will pray for you. Renew the spirit of holiness within him. They need to see you embracing celibacy as a sign of the kingdom of God, so that you freely and totally give your life to the bride, to the church. They need to see you as a priest who prays daily and consistently, silently in the presence of the Blessed Sacrament, meditating upon God's holy word. For only then can you offer a forceful witness of the gospel. And how is it that you specifically tend to God's flock, feed his sheep? You know, Vic, that the people are tired of the broken and the empty promises of the world. They know the great void those promises create. So the people in this day and age, just like in Jesus's, are hungering. They're thirsting for truth. The truth who is a person, the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who suffered and died and was raised for the dead for our salvation. Jesus Christ, who promises, as we celebrate at Pentecost, the giving of his Holy Spirit to be with us until the end of time. Feed God's people by the authentic preaching of his word. Instruct and inspire, not just in church. Go out to those who are lukewarm in their faith. Feed and nurture God's people in the sacraments, most especially in forgiving their sins and in giving them the body and blood of Jesus as you offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass. Feed and nurture God's people, especially the weak, the vulnerable, the most in need, by washing their feet, by imitating Jesus, the Good Shepherd, who came to serve and not to be served. And Vic, you understand. You understand that in carrying out this beautiful ministry, it's not you nurturing and feeding. It's the Lord, in whose person you stand, acting in and through you. And he promises to give you all the grace you need. He also gives you the gift of his mother. Stay close to Mary. Pray daily that beautiful prayer our Holy Father recently recited publicly. Mary, mother of priests, never tire of visiting me. Deliver me from danger. Console me. Sustain me. Come to my aid. And Vic, continue to depend on the love and support of your dear sisters and their family members and your many friends. Call upon the help of your beloved parents, who I am sure are looking down upon you this day with profound joy. Depend on the help of your brother priests. Collaborate with them, with the religious, and with the laity. As a seminarian, as you told me again last night, you have experienced in a profound way the love and the support of the lay faithful throughout this diocese. Trust me, that support will not waver. They love their priests, and we love them. And so together, we pray for you. We pray that through the intercession of St. John Vianney and Mary, our mother, you will always embrace a deep commitment to the spiritual life, so that you may offer a forceful witness to the gospel, that you will tend to God's flock in your midst and feed them in word and in sacrament, and that you will be a true servant who, through your priestly example and holiness and joy, will show God's people the way to heaven. Vic, soon to be my brother priest, God bless you, protect you always.